alam mo yung feeling na parang after office hours, tapos patutulog mo na yung kid mo, parang ayaw mo na mag-isip. So gusto mo parang mas passive na lang yung form of story time nyo. So this is kind of helpful, but kailangan siya effortan in such a way na you have to do the story time. Na you have to be more entertaining with the way you deliver the story and make it interactive too. Like with my daughter, what I do with her is kapag may nakikita ako dun sa story na familiar to her, I ask her what it is. Like for example, the boy who cried wolf. Parang once upon a time, there was a little boy who was a shepherd. What's a shepherd? And then if she doesn't know what it is, I'll tell her what it is. And then I'll tell her parang a shepherd is a person who takes care of sheep. What did the sheep say? Yan. Tapos nasagot siya. So, I'm excited siya sumagot all the time. So, she feels like she's part of the storytelling process. I mean, she's not just a viewer. And she really likes that. So, I'm hoping that your kids will like it too.
The sheep. What did the sheep say?
Bah.
Very good.
Bah.
One day, he got very bored. So he said, a wolf! A wolf! There's a wolf! Where's the wolf? They said. Where's the wolf? Tell us! Then the boy said, there's no wolf. I'm just kidding. Yes, just kidding. The villagers got mad because the boy lied. The next day,